Hello and welcome. In this video, I'll continue to explain text. In the previous lecture, we looked at the introduction of text, especially single line text. In this video, I'm going to explain multi-line text. The toolbar of multi-line text is available here on the ribbon in this annotative panel. And if you want to go with the command, then the shortcut for multi-line text is T only. You can simply type T at command prompt and press enter. It will ask you to provide two corners because multi-line text will require two edges to which the text is placed in. So I'm clicking one corner over here and drag to another corner over here. So M text will start, and you can observe that the text role has been shown here and other text formats are provided in case if you want to modify the text. So let's try to type some text here. If you press enter, it will keep adding new lines. It won't end as we have seen in the case of single line text. For this case, to end text, either we hold Ctrl key plus enter or we simply click close button over here. Now we have seen how to create text, both single line and multi-line text. So what is the difference between the two methods? Good question. The difference is clear. If you select a line from a single line text, only one line will be selected individually. So you have to select each in a click, whereas multi-line text, if you click only one line, the total line will be selected. That is a major difference. Let's create another text with the right justification in multi-line method. Type T at command prompt and press enter. Now it prompts to specify first corner. Click over here. At this point, there are more options available at prompt. Choose justify option and take middle right. Then it prompts you to specify opposite corner, and this will be my opposite corner. Let's type. As you can see, the text, they are aligned on right side. And if you want to close, press close tab editor. Then I would like to explain few more formatting options from multi-line text. Let's say if you want to highlight your text with bold letters, select that text and you can click capital B letter shown in the formatting group. As you can see, the letters are converted. You can also change the color of text. Let's choose green. Let's choose green like this. You can add on special properties to your text. Let's say you want to change the case of these letters to capital. You can do that. Simply right click and choose change case and here uppercase. As you can see, the selected text is in capital letter. And you can underline the text and convert to italic format if you want. And once you finish typing, close the editor so your text will look like this. Let's try middle justification. Type T at command prompt and press enter. Click first corner and go to justify option. Take middle center, then select second endpoint. Let's type again the same thing. All procedures in text are almost identical. All you need to focus is where you want to start your text. Is it right, center or left? Then after that, it is easier to decide if it is middle center, middle left or right. So as all the texts on the right are different in terms of alignment, and it is different from the left text in terms of method used when creating the text. Next, let's look how to change contents in the text. Both are same. You can type ed on your keyboard and press enter. It will ask to select annotative object. You can choose any text you want to edit. Let's say I have chosen this text. The moment you choose, it will be highlighted with a box. Type the new text you want to replace. I will type my name here and press enter. Enter again to end the command. Same thing can be applied in a multi-line text. Type ed at command prompt and select multi-line text and make some changes. Before that, you need to highlight the text, otherwise it's difficult to edit. To highlight, you can drag your cursor all over the text while pressing left side of your mouse, or you can simply hold Ctrl key and press A on your keyboard. In multi-line text, you will have more options here on the ribbon. If you want to change the size, it's over here, and others like bold, style, underline text, overline, italic, etc. Here we have font. You can set your own font like Times. How to set font we will cover in this chapter, no need to look at it now, but we explain how to set color earlier in this chapter. Here we also have justification. You can check which justification you are using, and you can change to any of these justification. Same way, you will have similar options here, but most important ones are mentioned here, like left, right, and center. You can also right click on your mouse. You will have more options like copy, cut, paragraph alignment. Paragraph alignment is nothing but justifications. We have explained that. Also change case, so many options to choose from. All of these like spell check, we will look in the following chapters. Next, let's look at font, how to change font that includes font style and font name. To initiate font dialog window, type ST and press enter to start with font name, and you can select any of the preferred font you want, and its preview will be shown while choosing the font. Whatever the font you select, that font will be used in the selected text style, and we can create as many as we need. That is, if you want to place a text with a different fonts within the same drawing, then we have to create different text styles. Let's try to create text style and use them in a drawing. So I'm erasing these things, and let's try to understand how to create text style. Type ST at command prompt and press enter. You'll get a dialog box like this. Now the default text style is standard, whose font is Arial. We will try to place our own text style, so click on new. I'll type Times and press OK. Why I chose text style as Times? It is because I would like to use Times New Roman as the font for this text style. Select this text style and go Times New Roman. Just press T on your keyboard, then it will be easier to get it. And this font, you will have bold, italic, regular. I will leave it as regular. Then come to height. Text height we can change manually, because here it will ask why you are using text height through command. So leave as 0. This is width factor. If you increase this factor, the text width will increase. Let's put a value greater than 0. Let's say 2.0. As you can see, each letter is widened by 2 times. Lastly, this is oblique angle. If you type 30, as you can see, all the text are angled with 30 degrees. And I want to create another one. Press new, type Swiss, and press OK. Open the font, type S on your keyboard, and search for Swiss 721CNPT. Apply and close. In the next lecture, we will complete this chapter.